how solar panels are made. Energy conversion happens everywhere under the sun, and that certainly includes solar panels that convert light energy into electricity. In fact, the photovoltaic conversion takes place in fragile cells inside the solar panel. However, a single cell cannot generate electricity on its own. So, several cells need to be connected and provided with a safe and reliable working environment in order to be used as a power resources. PV modules use glass, aluminum, frame, EVA, and etc. as the main packaging, auxiliary materials to provide protection for the cells. Maysun has undergone high-standard material selection, precise processing and manufacturing, and strict performance testing, so that high-quality PV modules can be used in different climate environments, providing guarantees for performance and durability. What is the internal structure of the solar panel that can resist rain and snow? Usually, the structure from top to bottom is PV glass, EVA, cells, EVA, back panel or PV glass, and aluminum alloy frame and junction box. However, making a high-quality solar panel is not just about assembling these materials, but it needs to go through a series of rigorous processes and pass a number of tests. In short, it takes 20 to 25 machines and a number of specialists to work closely together from the cells to module. The whole process involves around 10 major steps, which can be divided into several sub-steps to produce a complete solar panel. Step 1. Half cutting. In order to reduce current losses and increase module power, it's a good solution to use a laser cutter to divide the cells in two and switch to small area cells in series. However, this multiplies the number of connection points in the modules and places high demands on the production processes. The cut cells will be tested, and only those that pass the test will go on to the next step. Step 2. Welding. How are the individual cells connected to form a circuit? At high temperatures, the positive and negative poles of adjacent cells are connected using solder tape, which reaches its melting point and cools quickly, creating an effective, strong, and permanent physical connection between the cells, which in turn forms a string of cells. Here, it is subject to manual inspection before moving on to the next step. Step 3. Layout. How is the internal structure of a PV module built? Firstly, the cell strings need to be arranged on the PV glass covered with EVA. Next, the deflector strips are soldered to the solder strips on the both sides of the cell strings. So far, the preliminary circuit has been formed. In addition, the circuit layout is quickly fixed by means of the dispensing machines. It is worth noting that, in order to ensure the reliability of the solar strip once it is attached above and below the cell surface, a fixed distance of 2 to 5 mm should be maintained between the horizontal and vertical direction of each cell in the assembly. Through a reasonable design, some of the light irradiated in the solid of the cells can be projected onto the surface of the battery again after being reflected twice by the back plates and glass, so that the output power of the PV panel can be increased. If the arrangement of the cells determines the efficiency of the PV conversions, then the backplane laying determines how to export the current better. Lay the EVA and the backing plate in order to the cells after dispensing, and make the lead of the deflector strip pass through the holes onto the back plate. The current will also flow out of the cells along the lead. Step 4. EI testing. The final process before lamination. EI testing, in which module is scanned in the EI machine. We can easily spot any dead or low power cell, short circuit cell, cracks, and etc. If any such error is spotted, the module is sent back for fixing the error. Step 5. Lamination. The lamination is a decisive moment. While the glass, EVA, cells, and backsheet are tightly bound together by high temperatures to form the body of the module. Therefore, a final adjustment and testing is required before this to ensure that the laminate components are more reliable. Modules that pass the EI test are fed into the laminator for final shaping. After lamination, the modules are left for 10 to 15 minutes to cool down, till it reaches room temperature. Step 6. Frame. In order to make the assembly process more precise, modules need to be made uniform in shape and size by cutting the excess material at the edge. Afterwards, the staff will check the appearance of the cells. Once everything is in order, the cut aluminum frame can be tightly attached to the module by means of sealant. This not only provides full protection for the panel, but also prevents air, dust, and moisture from affecting the module. Step 7. Fixing junction box. The deflector strips extending from the back plate is where the junction box is mounted. Using sealant and soldering processes, the junction box is attached to the module to ensure that current can flow out smoothly. Step 8. Solidify and clean. After soldering, the module needs to be left to solidify for 10 to 12 hours to allow the structure to completely dry and reach a stable condition. After solidify process, the module needs to be manually cleaned to remove dust, foreign objects, or spilled sealant to present the assembly in its best condition. Step 9. Module testing. Once the module are manufactured, they will move on to the final three tests to ensure the high quality of the finished product. Firstly, an insulation resistance test will be carried out. DC current will pass through the component for 1 minute. If the panel can endure the current, it passed, else failed. The second is the power test. The output current, voltage, power, and etc. of the components will be tested and form a label information, and the staff will stick them on the backboard for distinction. Finally, the second EI test and visual inspection are carried out to minimize the detection error. Step 10. Packaging. After three final quality inspections, the staff will start packing the PV modules. In addition to packaging in cartons, the four edges of each module will be wrapped in a cardboard to prevent accident during transportation. After the packaging is completed, a film will be wrapped on the outside of the carton to better insulate air and moisture. As you can see, every Maysun solar panel, from the cells to the final delivery, will go through a standardized steps and strict test. Because of our insistence on product quality, we are able to provide consumers with a 15-year product warranty and a 25-year performance guarantee, allowing them to enjoy green and clean energy.